Morning dear students, so again we are going to start our computer subject, and in computer subject today we are going to start lesson number 2 on page number 12. So in this we are going to learn more about what is internet and how does it work, and what type of net we use, so what is the domain, what is the IP address, so each and everything in deeply we are going to learn about internet. So name of the lesson is already there, that introduction to internet. Introduction to internet, from lesson name it is clear that what is internet, what does it mean, and how does it work, how does we use, and what are the advantages and disadvantages we should keep in our mind. So as usual, our pink box, I am working on internet. I can do many things on internet, including purchasing items. So nowadays we buy a things or any product online. So that is also known, including purchasing item through help of internet. So your picture is given, boy is using a computer, and network, this is a sign of using network. And here the how globally all nowadays people are using computer network. So here it is a small define that internet is a collection of millions of computer. See, millions of computer, not one or two or hundred, it is millions of computer connected together with the help of, that is via satellite or dedicated links, either the satellite or the few links we can say. These computers that are connected over the internet can be sent and receive text, images, audio or video. So it is naturally clear that with the help of internet we can send or receive text message, image message, or we can send audio or video. So now on the page number 13 we will learn about the internet. What is internet? Internet is a worldwide computer network. Internet is the worldwide computer network. It consists of millions of computers that are spread and connected all across the world. See, not in the city, not in the country, but countries to continent, we can say overall the world. It is also known as network of networks, from network of networks. Clear? So internet is so widespread these days that there will be hardly be any country, city or locality in which it may not be there. Nowadays use of internet is so much that hardly any place, or we can say country or city or in a particular area, that they are not using net connection or not using computer. So here it is a small picture again given on the page number 13, that is globally here this is a sign, and countries like India, France, other countries, earshot pictures are given, USA, England and other countries. Okay, same thing. So how the globally network is used. Now objective of internet. Basic objective of internet is to establish a global connection so that people can share their information with each other. Now what is the use of internet? Main thing, from the base if we take, the use of internet is to share information with each other. Okay, and here it is a few famous here given. Internet has been derived from a network, ARPANET. ARPANET was developed at the US Department of Defense. So network is derived from the ARPANET, and ARPANET was developed at USA in the Department of Defense. Page number 14, we are going to go in the detail. We already know what is internet, and it is spread full we can say worldwide, across the world. And here is the type of internet. See, type of internet. Now what is the type of internet? It is two type of, are there, web server and web client. So you are the web client, you are the client using network. So we will learn in detail what is the web server. The content of web resides on web servers. It delivers the data requested by a web browser. See, web server, that is the main we can say portal where the data is, and data is transferred. So provide information to other. So whatever information you want, you will get from this. That is the web server, the main computer connection, main server, you can say, from where you are getting information. So this is the main thing. So in deeply we are going to learn that if computer in your school connected to internet for announcing a school result or internet and showing it to others, then this computer will be termed as web server. Okay, so you already you know that in your lab also main computer was there where nobody is going to use that server and you need to use the other computer. So first one was your web server, so you can say the main server of your school. And web server stores wide variety of data, information and service on them. So this is the few things you should keep in mind, that what is the web server. And if it is not clear, again it is given in the characteristic that they are very high speed computer and they work much faster than the basic computers. They have a large memory and they have a very large storage capacity. And they also remain connected to internet, that is 365 days a year and 24 hours a day, we can say. That web server, we can say, or you can say the main server of your school, okay. So that is connected 24 hour and 365 days. But when you go from the school, okay, school is closed, so that time teacher off the connection. But in the we say that the web server, there is the no off, they always remain on. So internet continues 24 hour and 365 days, that means full year. And in next session we will learn that what is web client, because everything will be mixed up in the mind. What is the internet? What is the use? How does it work? And what are the types? So first step we did today, that is the web server. That is the main computer which stores data, and it has a very fast speed, stores your data, has storage very large capacity. So this thing we are going to keep in mind. Okay, students. Thank you, everybody. Have a nice day.